So I figured out how to do something on Kittle that I haven't seen anybody else do, and that is create patterns with the graphics that are on Kittle. So I made this pattern right here. I'm going to show you step by step on how to do it, and you can use any graphics on Kittle and make thousands of different patterns. This is a game changer because you can use patterns on Redbubble, you can use patterns on Amazon, and a lot of different print on demand sites for tons of products. I'm going to show you how to do it step by step in this video. Let's go. Hey guys, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a pattern with Kittle. I'm gonna show you how to use the graphics. You can use as many graphics as you want. You can scale this up. You can use any of the graphics that you want and create your own unique pattern. And the amount of patterns you can create are endless. So I'm gonna show you how to do a simple one. And of course, you can modify it and do it the way that you want to do. So let's get into Kittle right now online, and I'll show you step by step on how to do it. And then I'm gonna show you how it looks like on Redbubble and Amazon. I'm gonna take that same file that we do, the PNG file, and I'm gonna upload it to Redbubble, and you're gonna see how cool it looks on all these products. So let's get to Kittle right now, and I'll show you how to do it. All right, so here we are on Kittle, kittl.com. You can see right here, still in beta, but they're pretty awesome. They're getting better and better, and now with this trick that I'm going to show you, it's even better to have a subscription to Kittle. So check out all the graphics. You can do this pattern thing with flowers. Look at the cool flowers they have here. Shapes, letters, of course, all of these stuff you can do with the technique that I'm going to show you that I just figured out. So you could do a snake pattern, you could do flowers. I'm going to do flower pattern, but you don't have to use flowers. You can use any graphics, right? So just follow along and I'll show you what to do. So I'm gonna do a new project here, and then I'm gonna make mine 3200 by 3200. And the reason for that is I want a square, first of all. And secondly, Amazon, the size that you need for phone cases need to be at least 3200. So I'm gonna do 3200 and you'll see how it looks like later. So I'm gonna hit create, and so we got a square right here. The next thing you wanna do is turn on some things. We're gonna turn on or turn off the trim view. That means we're gonna be able to use the whole artboard, and we're gonna turn on the grids just to help us see alignment and stuff like that. You don't need to turn on grids. I just like to do the grids, and you can use the whatever grids. You don't have to be the small grids. It can be just the big grids like that. All right. Next thing we're gonna do is find some graphics. So let's go here to elements, and then I'm gonna type in flowers for this example. Again, you can use whatever you want. Okay, so I'm just gonna take the first few here. This one here, this one here, this one here. It can be whatever. And I wanna make them a little bit different. So I'm gonna scroll down, maybe that one's a little different, and maybe have some variety with like a tall one. Well, that color doesn't really match. Let's look for, I have a tall one back here. Maybe this one. Yeah. This one? Just for a variety. Okay, I got six. You don't have to have six. Maybe I'll take this one out. Okay, five's good. You can do this with three, four, five, whatever. It doesn't matter. Okay, so let's put these down here. The first thing we're gonna do is make this bigger, and I'm gonna butt it up right here. So we're gonna butt it up against the corner. You see what I'm doing here? Right here, corner to corner. All right, and then we're gonna copy this. Hold down Option, we'll click on this, hold down Option, click, and drag. So we got two of these. And we're gonna take this outside of the lines here. So this one is touching the edge here, but this one's touching that edge here. And this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna grab both of them and kind of bring it in. Okay, holding down both of them, we're moving both of them at the same time. Don't cross this line, that's gonna be a little harder. We're just gonna cross this line. So whatever is here, it repeats here, right? So it's breaking the line here, but it's coming in here. And that's gonna give us the illusion or be able to replicate this pattern. And you'll see in Redbubble how when we do it, it's gonna just multiply and it'll be great. You'll see. Okay, so let's do another one here. Let's make this one bigger. We're just gonna fit it in. We're gonna take this one, Option, drag on the bottom here, and this one, hold both of them together and kind of fit it in the space that we want here. So maybe like that. You can see there's space here and there's space here. That's great. So now we got this breaking the top, but it's coming out through the bottom. So I kind of did the same thing here, and make sure they're aligned, right? So let's align it like that. There we go. So they're aligned. So when this comes up, it comes up here. And these two should be horizontally aligned. So do this one and that. Okay, perfect. Now, next thing we're gonna do is fill in the space here. So let's try this. This guy here, you can make it bigger and turn. Good. So we don't have to repeat this one because it's not breaking that line here. So let's do another one that will break the line. We got two here. Let's do this one. We'll do this guy. Maybe we can turn him sideways. Yeah. So 90 degrees here. And let's make him bigger to fill the space. Right there, that looks great. I'll move this guy. This guy's gonna be down here. And then again, make it touch there, hold down option. You see what we're doing here? And then click on both of these and make sure they're middle aligned. There we go. And then now that we have both of them, we can kind of put this where it needs to be, like that. Great. There we go. Okay, so now let's fill this space here. See, we got this. And we can make things bigger and smaller if it needs to fit. So maybe in this case, we're gonna make that a little smaller. And we can move this guy, right? Good, good, good. All right, and why don't we take this one and put him here. Maybe this big like that. That looks great, but you see it's breaking down here. So what we need to do is see how that touches. We're not gonna do it straight now. We're gonna do something a little crazy. You see how that right there touches? So do option, drag, and see how that touches right there. Perfect, kind of eyeballing it. And then we're gonna click both of these and bring it down, right? So both of these are, if you want to make sure that they're aligned here, center aligned, great. And you can see it's filling the space. So the only part we need to fill the space is right here. So let's fill it with one of these top ones. Maybe, no, that one's already right there. Let's see. Maybe if we turn this one, or we could just add another one. Let's add another one here since we have so many flowers. Let's do... right there. Oh, that's cool. And then maybe we'll do this one smaller. So I'm gonna come in here and make it smaller. Now I may need to break right here, so we could put it right there, right? So see how that's on the top right there? Hold down option, click on it and shift, and then we'll do it, make sure it's right there, and then hold down both and bring it like that. Okay, so then now we're gonna have to move this. So I hope you're following along. Whatever you do on the top here, you're gonna have to do on the bottom here. On the left here, or right here, you gotta do it on the left here, right? So you can see these two are breaking the edge. This one and this one's breaking the edge. This one and this one's breaking the edge. We may have to, you know, do something more like that. This one and this one are breaking the edge, so we can kind of move things around. Whatever you're, if it's breaking the edge, you're gonna have to move both of them. So now we can kind of adjust and move things around. That's good. Maybe to fill that space, yeah, so see that? And maybe make it smaller. Yeah, that's cool. All right, so now we don't have to totally fill the space. As long as there's some space in between, I think this is gonna be great. So let's turn off some of these things again. Let's turn off the show grid and turn off the trim view. You can see nice cool pattern like that. And we can leave the background transparent, or we can change the background to whatever color. So let's click the background. I'm gonna try black. Yeah, that's looking cool, but you can make the background whatever color. Look at that. So you can have multiple patterns like this. If you come in here and change the background to transparent, we're gonna do two. So I'll do one with transparent and one without. So let's do the black background first. I'm gonna download this and do PNG. You can see not remove background, but I'm gonna optimize quality. PNG there. So this one's downloading this pattern right here that we made. Again, you can use whatever graphics you want, right? You can see I've used it. I use more than four, but you could do it with four graphics. And then let's do remove the background and do a PNG. So this time it won't have the black background, and you can pick the background in Redbubble or Merch by Amazon or Amazon Merch on Demand. So let's get into Redbubble now, and I'll show you how this turned out. All right, so here we are on Redbubble. Real quick, we're gonna hit click upload new work, that right? And then I didn't name the project, you should have named it. But the last one we did was without the black background, and this one is with the black background. So let's do that one first. Of course, name your projects. I totally forgot that step. And then of course you can put your title, tag, description, whatever. I'm just gonna show you how it looks on products, okay? So you can see it takes a little while to upload because we used a graphic, probably a high res watercolor graphic flower, but let's see how it turns out. And here we are. I don't think it looks good on the clothing. It may look good on this tops here. And let's see, this is the test to see if it repeats. So I'm gonna hit edit and we're gonna choose pattern, but we're gonna do regular grid. Boom. Check it out. We can scale this, huh? Pretty cool, right? So I'm gonna do all these, upload them all, and then I'll come back and I'll scroll through them so you don't have to see me choose all the patterns, but I'm gonna show you what it looks like on all the different ones. All right, so I turned them all on, all the patterns. You can see it kinda looks good on the all over pattern, especially if the background is black. Kinda looks cool on the dress. Shower curtains and duvet covers look great. And just there's so many products on Redbubble that it looks great on. I would do the one that fills the whole thing. This tote bag doesn't fill the whole space, so I turned that off. But aprons, tops, and these down here, which a lot of people don't do, this looks great on a bag and a duffel bag and so on. So that's how you do it for Redbubble. Let me show you how to do it if you took out the background. So let's replace the image. I'll do this new project here. And then it's gonna load. It's gonna take a little while, so I'll show you what it looks like. All right, so here's the transparent background. Now I can just pick whatever background I want now and do blue right here, and you'll see it changed the background. So if I wanna do red, bring it down here, you know, it can change the color. So in this way, you can see it changes the color of the background, and I think it works really well. And you can still repeat it. So a lot of these took it off. So let's pick that color. And then you can see right there. And this way you can kind of try out different colors, or you know, have different versions of it. So let's go in here, enable this one. It works the same way though. So you have the regular grid, it still works with that color. And if you want a different color for your shower curtain than the main color, you can come in here and set this color to whatever you want too. So that's a nice thing about having it as a transparent. You can change different background colors for different products, right? So fun. And of course you can do that over and over again. So let's get into Amazon Merch on Demand. Let me show you how it works there. So here we are on Amazon Merch on Demand. You can see it's still loading. I uploaded the black background one, but you could do the same thing with the transparent background one and do it here. It's not gonna be great on t-shirts, but on here, on the pop socket, you can do it. Let's just make it bigger. See? Boom. On here, move this to the top. And let's just do all the way, right? And then you can move it to where you want it. All right? And that's pretty cool. Same thing with this one, all the way to the top, and then move it around. So you have some flexibility where you want to move it left to right. So if you want to do more like that, maybe that's more pleasing, you can do that. And then the tote bags and stuff also are great for patterns and pillows. Look at that. So you could upload these and have some really cool phone cases, tote bags, pillows, and pop sockets with patterns on them, and just upload those and not worry about these right here. So that's how cool it is to do, and you can put it on other ones. I didn't even touch on TeePublic and some of the other print-on-demand sites. So that's how easy it is to do patterns on Kiddo. Hopefully you follow along. If not, go back and watch it. Make sure that everything's aligned. Use that grid, and you can try out different graphics. So many different graphics on there. Lots of cool vintage flower ones, which will turn out really nice too. If you want to see another video on how to use Kiddo, you can click on this one right here. I have a full tutorial on Kiddo and all the other things that they do on there. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.